Hello friends, this is Roshni. So in this video, we are going to see about the issues in the design of code generation. So as we all know that the code generation is the last phase in the compiler, and this is going to get the input from the previous phases like intermediate code generator or code optimizer. So even it is going to get the input from the intermediate code generator, or it is not going to get the input from the code optimizer, which whether the code optimization is done or it is not done, the code generation is going to happen. The code generator is going to convert the intermediate representation of the source code in a form that is readily executable by the machine. So it is very important that we are going to generate the correct code. So the code should be in a way that it should be easily implemented, tested, and maintained. So these are all the issues arise during the code generation phase. That is input to code generation, target program, memory management, instruction selection, register allocation, and evaluation order. Let us see all this one by one. The first thing is input to code generation. So as we discussed, the code generation will get the input either from the intermediate code generator or from the code optimizer. So if it is going to get the input from the intermediate code generator, and it can be in any one of this form, either it can be in postfix notation or in syntax tree form or in DAG form. DAG means directed acyclic graph, or it can be in any one of these three address code forms like quadruples, triples, and indirect triples. So when this input to the code generation is given, it will be in an assumption that the input will be free from syntactic error, semantic error, and also all the necessary type checking has taken place. Also, it will assume that the type conversion has been inserted wherever necessary. So this is about the input to the code generation. So the next thing will be target program. So what is target program? Target program is the output of this code generator. So the output of the code generator will be in any one of these three forms. It can be in absolute machine language, or it can be in relocatable machine language, or it can be in assembly language. So if the output is in absolute machine language, which means, so it is going to place the program in a fixed location in the memory. So it is easy for the memory means RAM. So it is easy for the CPU to access it faster. So that is absolute machine language. Next is relocatable machine language. So here you know that subprograms and subroutines are allowed by the compiler to run, execute separately. And also it has so many other library files to be linked with the object code. So here what happens is the linker will link all this codes together, which means all the subroutines together, all the library files together, and it will be linking it as a one file, and it make us a one executable file. So this executable file will be placed in the memory with the help of the loader, and it will be placed wherever there is a free space available in the memory. And this linking and loading is processes little bit expensive. So this is what the relocatable memory location is, which means wherever there is a free space, it will be placed. That space is used for it. And the final one is assembly language. So for code generation, assembly language is very important, and it will be generated easily. So this is about the target program, which means the output of the code generation. So the next one is memory management. So you know that in a program, we may have so many names. These names will be mapped with the address of the data object with the help of rendend and the code generator. The name in the three address statement will be referring the symbol table, and the symbol table will give us the relative address of the name which we want to determine. So in every phases of the compiler, the symbol table will be used for memory management. So since from the symbol table only we are entering all the details, like what is the identifier, what is its type, what is the relative address, everything. So using the help of this symbol table accessible in every phase, memory management can be done. The next thing is instruction selection. So the quality of the generated code will be determined by its speed and the size. So the instruction we are going to select to generate the code is very, very important since it is affecting the speed and the size. So here this is an example. Let us consider this three address code. So for this three address code, let us create an assembly code. So for what is the first thing to do here? First, we are going to take the variable B. So B should be moved to the register. So we are moving the value in the B to R0 register. Then along with the B, C should be added. So we are adding C with RO, BC, because RO is already containing B. So C and the B will be added and the result will be stored in RO. Finally, this result want to be stored in A. So we are moving RO, the result is in RO, so that RO is now moved to A. So A now contain the result. So in the next instruction, we want A. So A is now available in A, so that want to be moved to RO. That is the register, R0 register. So then along with the A, we have to add E. So now we are adding E with RO, R0. So R0 is already contained A. So A and E is added and the result is stored in R0. So finally move this result to D. The result is already available in R0. So R0 is now moved to D. So here it takes 6 instructions to do this 3 address code generation. So this 6 instruction can be reduced to 4 by reducing this to statements. So here what we are doing, first we are moving the result to A. Again the A is moved to register. So this can be reduced. So here directly the result from R0 is taken and that is directly added with E. Instead of storing the result in a register, then from the register we are loading, that 2 steps is reduced. So directly the result from RO is taken and added with E. Then finally the result is stored in D from the register R0. So here we are reducing the size of the instruction. So that is also very important in the instruction selection. If you see in this example, so here A equal to A plus 1 and incrementation is done to the variable A. So if you write the assembly code of this, first we have to move A to register R0. Then along with that we have to add 1. So add the constant 1. So that is #1. The constant 1 is added with the register R0 and the result is stored in R0. Finally store the result in A. So move R0 to A. So this is how we can done. So this can be done also with a single instruction, increment A. So instead of 3 instructions, now we have only 1. And this is a register operator, increment. So it will be performed faster. So now from this example, we maybe notice that speed is also important, size is also important. So that determines the quality of the generated code. So that is about instruction selection. So the next thing is a register allocation. So we know that in a program, we may have so many number of variables for the computation. But the number of register available is very less. Also, the register is more faster when compared to the memory. And also, if you do a computation with the help of register, it is faster when comparing to the use of memory. So the use of register is subdivided into 2 sub-problems. One is register allocation and register assignment. So in register allocation, we select the set of variables that will be reside in the register. But in register assignment, we pick the register that contain the variable. So both are opposite to each other. So as the number of variable increases, the optimal assignment of the register is very important. So that is very difficult. So that mathematically, that is the NP complete problem. So this is about register allocation. So we have to efficiently use the register since it is more faster than access using the memory, even for doing any computation. So here is an example. So to do the division between X and Y, where X is a dividend and Y is a divisor. So here even register is used to hold a reminder, and odd register is used to hold the quotient. So the next is evaluation order. So the order in which the instruction executed is also very important to make the efficiency of the target code. So among many computation order, some will require only few registers. So because already we saw that register availability is very less. So when we follow some evaluation order, the register requirement will be less. So it is very important to select the evaluation order in a proper way. So that is again an NP complete problem. So these are all the issues when you do the code generation. Hope you have understand. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you.